People keep trying to ask, they ask me as to explain this. You know, how, when you're playing at Wimbledon, you say it's the greatest arena that you've ever been, you step in. They say that center court at Wimbledon is the mecca of tennis. You've said it many a year. But when you play Davis Cup, whether you play at the NSCI or the DLTA Stadium in Delhi, whether you play in Fréjus in the south of France against a formidable French team that have four top tens in the world, and you're playing on an alien surface, which is clay courts, you've never really grown up on the clay. What do you find as a solution to win? When I was younger, I didn't have an answer, because sometimes you just do what you do, right? You don't always have to find an answer or a reason to explain it, you just do it. But as the years have gone on, I've tried to break it down, and my humble explanation of that is, if you really deeply desire to achieve something, no matter what it is, if that burning desire is so strong, you will make sure that you surround yourself with the right team, the right people, and you will ask the right questions to then find a solution to be the best you can be.
Today, as much as I've been called up to interact with you on my personal life, on the learnings that I've had, the one key message that I'd like to interact with you and say is that the world is your stage. The world is your stage in any platform. So for this young little lady and boy, I grew up wanting to be an Olympian. I grew up wanting to emulate what my father had done.
Leander, congratulations on the title. If we start checking boxes, the dream is generally to play a Grand Slam, you've done that. It's to win a Grand Slam, you've done that. It's to represent the country, you've done that at the Olympics, more than once, six times to be precise. The dream is to win a medal at the Olympics, you've done that. What's left and what's pushing you further?
Fantastic question. This is something I've actually been trying to create, these new boxes, since last Saturday. You know, actually how I look at my chart of my career is with boxes. Few of y'all that are very close to me know that I basically go off my own personal list of checking off boxes. My dad has a whole bunch of boxes that he needed me to check. So we check those off. I've had coaches who've had their boxes that I need to check, so I check those off. I've had mentors, as in Naresh Kumar, Tony Roach, Bob Carmichael, Rick Leach, mentors that have helped me in my career that I've checked off their boxes. And my father's one of my biggest critics. And he's the first person to be there when I lose a match. And when I win a match, I almost had to call him because he waits for everything else to finish. And when Daddy turned to me after I won this and he said, "You know, Lee, you've literally made me very proud as a father because you've done everything any father could have asked for." I knew I had checked off every box. But I also think that in every human being's life, both as a professional as well as a human being, there are many boxes to check. So I continue playing tennis for my passion for the game. I continue playing tennis and I continue trying to win Grand Slams and create history to prove to every young Indian, why only young, every young and old Indian, that we can be world beaters. Just because I'm 43 years old, just like Paji said, in a couple days, doesn't mean I cannot create history again. Right now I share the maximum number of Grand Slam mixed doubles wins with one of my favorites. Martina Navratilova to me is one of the all-time greats. I grew up as a kid watching her on black and white TV, playing against Chris Evert, playing, you know, the fabulous French Open battles that she played. And then to share a stage with her in the history books, it's tough to explain in words, you know, I mean, she's really something else. But she's the one who's also taught me about longevity. She's taught me how to create new boxes. I'm still one more win away from honoring her and bettering that benchmark. And that's what I'm playing for. I'm playing for passion. I'm playing to motivate every human being that I meet to be the best that they can be. One day the curtain's going to come down. Whether it's at the Olympics, I don't know. Whether it is at the next Grand Slam I win, I don't know. Whether it's 2 years, 3 years down the track, I don't know. But I'll tell you this. If I wake up 31 days in a row, 1 month in a row, 31 days in a row, and I don't enjoy my game of tennis, whether it's physically, mentally, travel, or anything, on that 32nd day, I'm done.
Surrounding yourself with a good team, surrounding yourself with good quality people, their skills do not have to match. Their passion and then their enthusiasm for excellence needs to match. You get people from different skill sets that bring to the table their speciality in their way. But at the end of the day, it's up to each and every one of you to set a vehicle of communication, to set a methodology of understanding what they're trying to say. And when you really ask them the right question and really understand what they're saying to you, then to break that down and doing it in your style. I wouldn't be without where I am today without my team. And that's why I honor them every time I come up to speak.
And my training methods evolve continuously. I love learning new things from other athletes. I ask very relevant questions to people who are knowledgeable about fitness, mental toughness, technique. And it's amazing how you can learn from every walk of life. So for me, being a student of the game of tennis, being a student of life, as much as I'm answering your questions, I'm also learning. And usi mein hamare evolution hota hai. Because if I go to the Olympics, I have 10,000 athletes in a village in all different walks of life. So I'll share one little anecdote with you. I'll share one little secret with you because I don't want to give too many secrets away. But age is just a number.
For me, the vehicle to get to the Olympics was almost as important as playing in the games itself. Why? Because I do not believe I'm the most talented athlete. I believe I'm the most passionate athlete. I believe that the homework that I have to do, the recognition of where I am today and where I want to be tomorrow is more important. And that bridge that I have to go from being a talented young boy to then becoming a world champion is actually a life journey.
And for every single fan that reaches deep into their pockets to come out and pay for the ticket to watch me on a stage, to watch me on a tennis court, to watch me in a movie theater with a bag of popcorn in hand, I have a duty to them, I have a responsibility to them to be the best I can be. I won't win every match, not every movie will be a blockbuster. But I guarantee you that every time I step out there to be the best I can be, I am getting better. And I will definitely put my best foot forward. I'm not out there to please everybody. I'm not out there to make every single person happy. No, I'm not there to be fake. I'm there to be me. I'm there to do the things that matter to me. Whether it's motivating the young children, whether it's motivating young India, whether it's going out there into the corporate world to bridge a young kid coming out of college with aspirations and dreams to be world beaters, for those corporates to have great foundations and great systems in place to encourage the youth of the country. If I can be the bridge to create better opportunity for young India, 100% I will do it. That's what I'm here today for.